Susret. Emisija u kojoj susrećemo poznate ili manje poznate, ali svakako ljude zanimljive i vrijedne pozornosti.
Na valovima radio postaje Mir Međugorje i vi ih možete susresti.
Dragi slušatelji radio postaje Mir Međugorje, srdačno vas pozdravljamo u emisiji Susret. U ovoj emisiji imamo zaista zanimljive goste, troje gostiju, troje Engleza. To je mladi Thomas Tom, njegova majka Katarina i gospodin Billy. No, najbolje da se oni sami predstave, a ja ću samo reći da je poticaj za razgovor došao od gledanja Toma. Svi koji su češće u Međugorju na svetim misama mogli su primijetiti jednoga mladića koji je u invalidskim kolicima, ali uvijek radostan i nasmijan. Svake večeri na svetoj misi i na raznim drugim slavljima, između ostaloga, mladići iz Međugorja su uzeli nosiljku i na Veliki petak nosili ga uz brdo Križevac do vrha. Sve ih lijepo pozdravljamo u našem studiju, a razgovor će prevoditi Tea Sušac.
My name is Thomas Lascelles and I'm from Newcastle upon Tyne in the northeast of England. I'm 20 years of age and I have cerebral palsy, which means that I cannot walk and I'm a wheelchair user.
Dakle, ja se zovem Tom Lascelles i dolazim iz grada koji Newcastle u sjeveroistočnoj Engleskoj. Imam 20 godina i imam cerebralnu paralizu, što znači da sam u kolicima i ne mogu koristiti svoje noge.
Od kada ste u kolicima?
I was born in a wheelchair, so I was born as a twin, and I had a twin, but the twin passed away at birth from the cerebral palsy, but luckily I survived.
Od rođenja sam imao tu bolest, dakle cerebralnu paralizu, i jedno sam od dvoje djece blizanaca koji su se rodili. Drugo dijete, nažalost, zbog cerebralne paralize nije preživjelo rođenje, a ja sam im bio blagoslovljen i ipak sam rođen.
Koliko vas ima djece?
I have two older sisters, one sister who is around 26 years of age and the other sister who is around 30 years of age.
Imam dvije starije sestre, jedna ima 24 i jedna 28 godina.
Tom, jeste li uvijek bili tako radosni, tako nasmijani od djetinjstva unatoč vašem hendikepu?
Well, having a disability, it's been a very long journey. I've always been a wheelchair user, but I used to be able to walk with a walking frame, with a walking aid.
Što se tiče života sa poteškoćama, dakle, sa invaliditetom, u početku nisam bio u kolicima, nego sam mogao koristiti hodalicu i hodao sam uz pomoć hodalice.
But I used to be able, as I said, I used to be able to walk, but then I received three operations which didn't go to plan, and they ended up being an error, resulting in me spending most of my years past the year of 2008 in a wheelchair.
Nažalost, kasnije sam imao tri operacije i pokazalo se da su te operacije bile pogrešne zbog pogreške liječnika. Ja sam od 2008. većinu svog vremena u kolicima.
But from the beginning I never let the wheelchair stop me, and during this period of the operations I was very fortunate, thank God, to have a very, very good Catholic priest who guided me through this.
Nikada nisam dozvoljavao da me da je poteškoća, odnosno invaliditet, one sposobi. Imao sam veliki blagoslov da sam u sebe imao katoličkog svećenika koji me čitavo vrijeme vodio kroz ovaj proces, kroz ovo putovanje.
And he led me through this spiritually, and then I was very lucky because I was very fortunate because I had a pretty much normal upbringing. I went to a normal Catholic high school.
Recimo da sam ja bio jako, jako, imao sam sreću. On me je vodio, a ja sam, moj život do tada je bio onako, običan život. Katolički sam odgojen, doživio sam taj katolički odgoj u svojoj obitelji.
And then I also managed to successfully pass all of my exams and all of my studies in high school, even though I was having this treatment in hospital at the time.
I evo, srećom sam uspio završiti sve ispite u srednjoj školi, sve položiti, čak i usprkos tim operacijama koje su bile u to vrijeme.
So getting back to the question, I've always been happy, yes, because for me a disability was all about making a disability the ability.
Dakle, evo da se vratim na, kao, da odgovorim na vaše pitanje. Da, ja sam od uvijek bio ovako sretan. Ja sam se uvijek tražio način da od ove poteškoće napravim neku vrstu, neke sposobnosti.
And very much of my faith came, very much of my joy and my happiness came from my relationship with this priest. His name was Father Michael Corbett. And also my Catholic upbringing. I was always brought up as a Catholic.
I većina radosti koju ja posjedujem i sreće koju osjećam dolazi iz činjenice da sam odgojen u katoličkoj obitelji i iz odnosa sa tim svećenikom koji se zove velečasni Michael Colbert.
So I soon learned that you know, the disability in comparison to faith and to God was very little to worry about, and that you know, I was a child of God and that I was very important to God. So I soon learned to put everything to one side and to carry my cross.
Uskoro sam nekako naučio da taj život s poteškoćom, sa invaliditetom, u usporedbi kada se gleda u kontekstu Boga, je doista mali, neznatan. Ja sam nekako uspostavljao sam svoj odnos s Bogom i počeo sam sebe doživljavati kao Božje dijete.
With as much joy and with as much happiness as I could, I learned that I could have taken the approach of having a disability, of, you know, seeing my life as different to everybody else and seeing that I wasn't able to do what everybody else was able to do.
Dakle, što se tiče tog invaliditeta, poteškoće koju sam imao, ja sam mogao živjeti život misleći što sve ja nemam i što sve ja ne mogu i što su sve te stvari koje ja neću moći učiniti u usporedbi sa ostalima koji su drugačiji, odnosno ja bi bio drugačiji u odnosu na njih.
But instead I took the view of that I'm here for a reason. And it's up to me to make the most of that reason, and to try and figure out what my reason on this earth is, and to try and make my life and everybody else's life as easy and as happy and as joyful and as best as it could possibly be.
Umjesto toga, ja sam počeo promatrati svoj život kao da postoji razlog zašto sam ja ovdje. Dakle, ja sam pokušavao otkriti koji je razlog zašto sam ja tu i pokušavao sam vidjeti kako ja mogu, dakle, svoj život učiniti svrhovitim i što više sretnim, radosnim u odnosu na druge ljude, tako da ja ispunim tu svrhu zbog kojih sam ja bio na zemlji.
Hail Mary, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. You were chosen by the Father. You were chosen for the Son. morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. In turn, all women too. Blessed they with peaceful spirits. Blessed they with gentle hearts. Gentle woman, quiet love. Bright, gentle mother, oh peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love, teach us wisdom.
Sada ćemo pitati Toma kada je prvi put došao u Međugorje, kada i kako je uopće čuo za Međugorje i zašto je došao u Međugorje.
It's a very long story, but I will try to sum it up as quick as I can.
Dakle, to je jako duga priča, ja ću pokušati nekako skratiti što više mogu.
Because as many people know, I can talk for England. I talk a lot. So.
Jer mnogi ljudi znaju da mogu dugo puno pričati.
So I first came to Medjugorje in July 2015 for a week with Marian Pilgrimages.
Dakle, prvi put sam došao sa agencijom Marijanska hodočašća 2015. godine u srpnju kao hodočasnik na tjedan dana.
I was invited by my friend brother Senan Ryan, who I knew as an Irish Christian brother. And I was talking to him at the time over Skype about my vocation and about my life.
Pozvao me je jedan brat, on je član reda Kršćanska braća, zvao se brat yeah. Senan Ryan, i mi smo u to vrijeme čuli se često preko Skype-a i razgovarali smo tako, ja sam pričao s njim o svom pozivu, o onome što sam osjećao u svom srcu.
And as a joke, I said to brother Senan, I said, we were just having a general conversation and I asked where he was going on holiday and he told me Medjugorje. So I then asked him as a joke if I could come with him, go with him.
Dakle, ja sam pričao s njim, vodili smo onako običajan razgovor, ništa posebno. Pitao sam ga gdje planira ići na godišnji odmor i on je kazao da ide u Medjugorje. Tad sam ja onako više iz šale rekao, mogu li ja poći s tobom?
But unbeknown to me, this joke soon turned serious and soon turned into a reality. And before I knew it, I'd arrived in Medjugorje with brother Senan for the week. And I had an absolutely amazing week. I didn't know what to expect, but believe me, I received much more than I could ever have expected.
Dakle, ta šala, nešto što je izrečeno samo kao šala, je uskoro postala stvarnost. Ja sam došao u Međugorje na tjedan dana sa bratom Senanom i dogodilo se da je taj tjedan bio nevjerojatan. Ja sam primio toliko milosti i toliko darova i uopće ne mogu objasniti kako je taj tjedan prošao i što se dogodilo, ali znam da je bilo onako nevjerojatno.
So I received so many graces. I had so many blessings, more than I could ever have imagined to have received. It was an absolutely phenomenal week. I met so many amazing pilgrims and people, and it was great to spend time with Brother Senan. It was the first time I'd ever met him in person.
Dakle, to je bilo prvi put kad sam ja upoznao brata Senana. Bilo nam je, ono, da smo se upoznali uživo, bilo nam je divno da smo mogli biti skupa, ali sve to što se događalo tog tjedna, sve milosti, svi blagoslovi, svi kontakti, svi ljudi, hodočasnici, svi su bili čudesni i nevjerojatni. Bilo je doista jako posebno.
So, after this week, we returned to England and And I went via Ireland at the time. I live in England, but I went via Ireland, and I remember when we were in Dublin Airport.
I tada, sjećam se kad sam se vratio doma, letio sam preko Irske, iako živim u Engleskoj, bili smo na dublinskom aerodromu.
That I'd said to Brother Sen and I more or less said, we must book up same time, same place next year.
I sjećam se nešto kako sam mu rekao, moramo obojica rezervirati putovanje, isto putovanje na isto mjestu u isto vrijeme do godine.
So we came in July 2016 again for a week. And again, it was an even better week, even bigger, better, more than I could ever have imagined.
I opet smo se vratili do godine u srpnju 2016. godine i to je bilo čudesan tjedan. Primio sam puno, puno više nego što sam mogao zamisliti da ću primiti.
And then after this week again, we returned to, I went via Ireland. And I remember I said to Brother Senan in the airport, I said, I think I'm going to go back there.
I opet sam se vraćao preko Irske i opet sam bio u zračnoj luci u Dublinu i tada sam rekao bratu Senanu nešto tipa, mislim kako ću se ponovno vratiti tamo.
And Brother Senan more or less looked at me and I don't think he thinks I was being serious, but I think he meant that I was going to come back July 2017 with him again for a week.
Ja mislim kako je tada me brat Senan me pogledao, nisam siguran da je bio ozbiljan, da je mislio išta drugo, da sam ja mislio u tom trenutku, nego on jednostavno mislio, ok, ja ću sigurno doći ponovno u srpnju 2017. godine.
But I knew deep down in my heart that I had actually received a grace in Medjugorje, and I had actually received a certain desire to return to Medjugorje sooner.
I ja sam znao što sam osjećao u svom srcu. To je bila milost i to je bila čežnja koju sam ja osjećao da se ja vratim što prije u Međugorje.
But there was one problem in that it wasn't a problem for me, it wasn't a problem, but for everybody else it was. And that was that I felt that I wanted to go alone back to Međugorje.
A ono što sam ja osjećao za druge je bilo problem, međutim za mene to nije bio problem. A ja sam osjećao kako se ja želim vratiti samo u Međugorje.
I didn't want the structure of a group. I didn't want anybody with me. And I just wanted to do everything between me, God and Our Lady.
Ja sam znao da ne želim biti dio grupe, da ne želim biti okružen ljudima, da želim biti posve sam i da to bude nešto što će biti između mene, Boga i Gospe.
And this was because I felt I needed a time of discernment in Medjugorje and just a period of to really discover on a much deeper level who Jesus and Mary actually were.
Ja sam osjećao kako je to razdoblje meni bilo potrebno, jer je to trebalo biti razdoblje razlučivanja i ja sam u tom razdoblju trebao otkriti na nekoj dubljoj razini tko su bili Isus i Marija, tko su oni bili.
So I decided that at the time I was actually doing a business administration apprenticeship, but during the summer holidays it was August 2016, I decided to book a 2-week holiday.
I tada sam ja, iako sam ja, dakle, radio praksu, bio sam u nekoj poslovnoj školi i bio je kolovoz 2016. Ja sam svejedno odlučio uzeti odmor i odmaknuti se od toga.
Because I knew in my heart of hearts that this apprenticeship was a good thing and that, you know, the people were good, the money was good, it was my first ever job, and... But I knew deep down that it wasn't my calling.
Ja sam nekako, iako je to što sam radio, ta praksa u toj poslovnoj školi bila nešto dobro, ja sam mogao, dakle, izrađivao sam prvu plaću, ljudi nisu bili loši, uvjeti su bili dobri, ali ja sam znao da to nije bio moj poziv.
So after the 2 weeks, I had an incredible 2 weeks. I was free, I was on my own, and it was incredible.
I nakon 2 tjedna bio sam 2 tjedna sam, bio sam slobodan, bio sam posve sam, bilo mi nevjerojatno.
I decided to take the decision to actually cancel my flight and to quit the apprenticeship.
I tad sam donio odluku da ću otkazati let za povratak doma i da ću potpuno prekinuti sa tom praksom koju sam radio.
And I rang my family and of course they didn't to an extent they understood but they thought I was a bit crazy.
Ja sam tada pozvao svoju obitelj, nazvao sam ih i nekako mi je činilo se da me razumiju, kao ono, razumiju me, ali mislili su da sam malo poludio.
But I knew 100% that it was the right decision.
A ja sam 100% u sebi znao i osjećao da je to bila ispravna odluka.
And basically I've been in Medjugorje on and off, going, I've been, you know, every couple of months I go back to England for a while, but I've been on and off in Medjugorje since August 2016.
I eto, od kolovoza prošle godine, manje više sam bio u Međugorju stalno, svako par mjeseci bi se vratio u Englesku na par tjedana, ali opet se vraćam ovdje i tu sam.
Gdje pri tome stanuješ? Ipak su tu invalidska kolica, trebaš li pomoć, kako uspjevaš se brinuti o sebi i koliko sudjeluješ na molitvenom programu?
It's a very good question, but basically I've never been happier in my life.
Dakle, ja nikada nisam, to je dobro pitanje koje ste mi postavili, ali ja vam nikad nisam bio sretniji u svom životu od kad sam ovdje.
And everything came from the grace of God.
I sve što je tu došlo Božjom milošću.
For approximately the first 6 months, I lived out of a suitcase, jumping from hotel to hotel in Medjugorje.
I otprilike prvih pola godine sam nekako živio s koferom u ruci stalno, selio sam se iz pansiona i iz hotela u hotel.
But I spent every day in a deep relationship with God. I go to mass twice a day every day. I go to adoration most days and I fully participate every day in the evening prayer program.
I evo tada sam u tom razdoblju sam i vodio intenzivan molitveni život, vodio bi intenzivan molitveni život, išao bi na dvije svete mise svaki dan, potpuno bi sudjelovao u večernjim programu od početka do kraja, išao na klanjanje presvetom sakramentu.
And I now am using an apartment that somebody is renting me.
A sada sam u stanu koji mi netko iznajmljuje.
And I'm very much I live all alone. I'm very thankful to God in that I can look after myself. I'm fully independent.
I živim sam i Bogu sam zahvalan da sam posve neovisan.
And I've never been in a more better position. I spiritually, mentally, physically, I am doing so good.
I recimo da ja se nikad nisam nalazio u boljoj poziciji nego što sam sada, i duhovno i mentalno i fizički. Dobro mi ide i jako sam zadovoljan.
And since I've been in Medjugorje, I have received a lot of support from the local people, everybody in Medjugorje, but especially I have built a great relationship and a very precious friendship with the priests of the community here.
I evo, otkad sam ovdje, ja sam upoznao mnoge ljude i mnogi ljudi mi pomažu, ali izgradio sam dubok odnos sa svećenicima koji su ovdje. I prijateljstvo.
I now use this apartment in Chok of Dolat, and I spend every day and spend my time in Medjugorje continuing to reflect on what it is that God wants me to do with my life and growing in my relationship with Jesus and Mary.
I evo ja vam sad živim u tom stanu na Čorkovom docu. Svaki dan pokušavam razmatrati i razlučiti što je to što Bog želi od mene u mom životu i trudim se izgraditi dublji odnos sa Isusom i Marijom.
And also you mentioned how do I live, you know, considering I'm in a wheelchair. The simple answer is that it all comes from the power and the grace of the Holy Family, and also because I have never seen this is a problem, and it never has been a problem.
Dakle,
my evo, disability.
Vi ste me pitali kako to je da ja živim sam, budući sam u kolicima i imam invaliditet. Međutim, ja nikada nisam vidio to kao poteškoću, a činjenica da sam sam, da sam neovisan je isključivo milost i sve zasluge idu u svetoj obitelji, njezinom zagovoru, a meni živjeti sam nije nikada predstavljalo problem.
Yes, I have small problems in such as certain physical things around the house, but I have very good friends who are always ready and eager to help me.
I nekada imam neke manje poteškoće, probleme u snalaženju u stanu, ali imam jako dobre prijatelje koji su uvijek voljni pomoći mi u tome.
And I always remember, because it is easy to get yourself down. And I do have up and down days with a disability. Even though I always seem happy, I do get down. But I always remember one thing, and that is my weakness is somebody else's strength, but my strengths are somebody else's weaknesses.
Dakle, činjenica je da ja, iako i uvijek izgledam onako vesel i radostan i nasmijan, i ja imam svoje poteškoće i probleme i one trenutke kada nekako padnem u duhu i bude mi teško. Međutim, ja se nekako uvijek trudim izvući gledajući to ovako. Dakle, ono što je moja slabost je možda nečija snaga, ono što je nečija snaga je možda moja slabost i to me nosi.
Razgovor s Tomom ćemo se vratiti nakon što čujemo njegovu mamu i njegovoga prijatelja kojemu zahvaljuje i dolazak u Međugorje. studiju je i gospođa Katarina, tako bismo mi to kazali u hrvatskom jeziku. Dobrodošli. Kako ste i kada vi saznali za Međugorje? Kako ste došli prvi put? Je li to bilo sve u svezi s Tomom?
Well, I'm ashamed to say that I had never heard of it until the first time Tom wanted to come over. I had known Billy for about 40 years, but I hadn't seen him for a long, long, long time, and I knew he came every single year. So Tom was also very interested in becoming a brother. And so I put him in touch with Billy to discuss it and see if it was feasible. So that's how the pair of them met.
Okay.
And as Tom said, he asked him, was he going on holiday? And he ended up going on holiday with him. That was the first time I'd actually heard of Međugorje.
Dakle, evo, stid me priznati, ali nažalost ja sam prvi put čula za Međugorje tek onda kada je Tom rekao da želi tu doći tjedan dana sa Billyjem koji je bio moj prijatelj. Međutim, mi se znamo dugo, dugo godina, ali skoro 40 godina nismo bili ni u kakvom kontaktu i nismo imali uopće nikakvih veza. Billy je u tom vremenu išao svake godine u Međugorje i onda kada je Tom, moj sin, rekao kako razmišlja o pozivu i kako treba to razlučiti, ja sam pomislila da ne bi bilo loše da se čuje i razgovara sa Billyjem koji je bio moj prijatelj. Tako su se ni dvojica spojili, tako je došla ta ideja da on dođe na godišnji odmor u Međugorje tjedan dana.
We could not sway Tom. We were so shocked when Tom came over last year and decided to stay. We just did not see that coming.
Dakle, mi smo bili u pravom šoku kada je Tom prošle godine rekao kako želi ostati u Međugorju. Nama se to činilo apsolutno nemoguće i neprihvatljivo.
I cried at him to come home. I shouted at him to come home. I threatened him to come home. He was insistent. This was the place he was meant to be and he was not coming home. End of the subject.
I evo nekako ja sam tada, jel, bila sam u šoku i pokušavala sam na sve moguće načine njega uvjeriti da se vrati doma i plakala sam, vikala sam, derala sam se, prijetila sam. Međutim, on je bio onako uvjeren da je to mjesto na kojem on treba biti i bio je nepopustljiv.
From a mom's point of view, as Tom said earlier, he was born 9 weeks early, he was a twin, we lost the twin, he spent years in hospital. Years, so he was always special. I always thought that God looked around to find somebody to have this special baby, and he chose our family, and we were privileged to have a special baby that God has given us to look after. And he has had a hard time, a very, very hard time. And we all thought he'd be at home for the rest of his life with us.
Iz moje perspektive kao majke, ja sam doživljavala, dakle, Tom je rođen kao blizanac i rođen je kao dijete koje je preživjelo, druga beba je umrla, ali on je uvijek bio, dakle, on je proveo godine i godine u bolnici zbog svoje bolesti. Međutim, ja sam nekako to počela doživljavati kao, budući on stvarno bio posebno dijete, kao da je Bog tražio neke posebne ljude kojima će dati tako posebno dijete u kojem će se oni brinuti i to je bio Tom za nas. On je doista bio dar od samog početka.
So eventually, this year, I had to come and see what he was up to, what was happening, and a little bit more about this place, and I'm stunned. It is absolutely nothing like I expected. Nothing.
I evo ja sam nekako, dakle, budući je on došao ovdje, odlučio živjeti ovdje, biti ovdje, boraviti ovdje, ja sam morala doći da vidim o čemu se tu radi. I malo reći da sam ostala začuđena i nekako zabezeknuta sa svime što je ovdje, jer ovo nisam uopće očekivala ovako nešto.
I mean that in a good way. Not a bad way.
Yes.
So, yes, I found it very, very emotional. I found it very, very... There is definitely a feeling around the place that I didn't expect this. And I'm not really a one to believe is... I mean, I'm a Catholic and I believe in God, but I've never felt this sensation that we've had here.
Dakle, od samog početka kad sam došla ovdje, ovdje se definitivno može nešto osjetiti, kao da se stalno osjeti nešto što je prisutno u zraku. I ja uopće nisam imala takva očekivanja, ne znam ni što sam očekivala, katolik sam, vjernik sam, vjerujem, ali ovo je posve drugačije od onoga što sam ja i zamišljala i očekivala.
A mass last night at communion, there was a dove arrived, landed on the top of the cross, on top of the above the altar, and that was just something about it that made that I've never seen a bird sit as long, or a dove especially, and it was just so special, and it stayed, communion finished, off it went.
Evo, recimo, ja sam sinoć za vrijeme svete mise, dok je trajala pričest, vidjela sam tu golubicu koja je sletila na križ, na vrhu vanjskog oltara, i to je bilo tako čudan prizor, dakle, da golubica sleti, da bude tu, način na koji je ona sletila, i točno kada je završila pričest, kako ona uzletila i otišla. Dakle, to su neke stvari, jeli, koje su čudne, koje ne zamišljate, ne očekujete, a vidite ih i doživite ovdje.
A je li ovo vaš prvi dolazak u Međugorje?
This is my first time, yes. Yes. But hopefully I'll be back.
A nadam se da ću se vratiti.
I'll be back, only.
Kazat ću našim slušateljima kako je i Tomova mama došla u invalidskim kolicima do Bežena. Zašto, o čemu se radi, možete li ukratko reći?
Yes, I'm a nurse, I'm a midwife, and I couldn't read the doctor's writing. Doctors always write badly, but it was too bad. And my vision was gone, and I went to my doctor, who did a full health test, and he said I have patches of multiple sclerosis in my head and in my back. I'm not on a wheelchair all the time, but there is sometimes when I'm bad, I do need it. There's not a lot else I can say about that. That just came as a shock and a surprise, and they can't make it better, but hopefully they can treat it.
Dakle, evo, ja sam medicinska sestra po zanimanju, babica, i jeli, većina liječnika, njihov rukopis je nečitljiv, međutim, počelo je tako da ja nisam uopće mogla pročitati ono što bi liječnice napisali na poslu, i onda su jeli, počeli raditi različite pretrage i utvrdilo se da imam multiplu sklerozu koja se počela javljati u nakupinama oko očiju i u gornjem dijelu prsa i torza. Ja nisam u kolicima stalno, ali kada mi je loše, moram ih koristiti, i evo, to je, ta bolest je došla i kao iznenađenje i kao šok. Ne može se izliječiti, ali nadamo se da je barem mogu liječiti i nekako sanirati.
The people of Medjugorje are amazing.
Ljudi u Međugorju su predivni.
Everybody knows Tom.
Yes.
Every five or six steps, it's, oh, hello, Tom. Oh, you're Tom's mother. Everybody. The shops, the cafes, the taxi drivers, everybody. And they've all been waiting to meet me as well. That's all he's done, is taken me around and your mum's here, and oh, cuddles. And yeah, they've been amazing with them. I feel a lot more comfortable now that I've seen what it's like and the people. I can go home feeling a lot more comfortable about where he is and what he's doing.
Dakle, evo, ljudi u Međugorju, htjela sam reći kako su ljudi u Međugorju prekrasni i predivni, kako su svi topli, kako svi poznaju Toma, kako svako 5-6 koraka nekoga pozdravlja, od taksista, od ljudi u trgovinama, ljudi na ulici, i meni je to čudesno da su ljudi tako otvoreni, da su tako dobri prema njemu, i nekako sada ja kao majka imam puno više sigurnosti, mogu se vratiti kući s tim osjećajem sigurnosti da je njemu dobro i da je on na sigurnom mjestu.
A na ovo sigurno mjesto Toma je na neki način doveo gospodin Bilirijan, pa će nam i on reći nešto o svom iskustvu Međugorja, prvim dolascima, kada je prvi puta došao, zašto i kako je njegovo iskustvo Međugorja.
I came here for the first time in 1995, and I'd heard about Međugorje in 1987.
Dakle, ja sam prvi put došao 95. godine, a 87. sam čuo prvi put za Međugorje.
Before I'd heard of Međugorje, I'd heard of Fatima, I'd heard of lots of different places where Our Lady had appeared. I never could understand why she couldn't appear today.
I prije nego što sam čuo za Međugorje, čuo sam za Fatimu, čuo sam za Lourdes, čuo sam za različite ukazanja, i stalno sam se pitao zašto se Gospa ne ukazuje danas, baš u ovom vremenu.
I thought I'd never come here. I thought it. So after 8 years, I eventually came here in 1995. and it was everything I expected and better. It was wonderful.
I onda, u to vrijeme kad sam čuo da se Gospa ukazuje jedno mjesto, da se ukazuje Međugorju, za sebe sam mislila da nikad sigurno neću tamo otići. A 95. godine sam ipak prvi put došao i to je bilo čudesno, prekrasno iskustvo koje ja nikad neću zaboraviti.
My circumstances changed about 2000 and I managed to come out every year since. It is fantastic. I look forward to it and the days before I come here I feel like I'm walking on air. And when I get here then it's just like heaven.
I ja sam nekako od 2000. godine, okolnosti u mom životu su se promijenile na način da ja mogu svake godine doći ovdje i ja tu nastavim doći svake godine, barem jedan put, a svaki put prije nego što dođem, prije nego što boravim ovdje, osjećam se kao da sam u nebu, kao da hodam po zraku, dakle, doslovno lebdim prije nego što dođem od uzbuđenja i radosti.
And when I get on the bus to go home, I'm crying inside.
A onda kada sjednem na autobus, kad se moram vratiti doma, tada plačem i tužan sam što moram ići doma.
I can't communicate to my family how much Međugorje means. So when Tom said he'd come, I was over the moon. I was really happy.
Ja nekako imam problem da svojoj obitelji objasnim što je Međugorje, što se tu događa. I evo, kada je Tom izrazio želju da želi tu doći, ja sam bio preradostan, ja sam bio tako uzbuđen i tako sretan da je to bilo predivno.
And then just came over with Marian Pilgrimages and with Tom and we had two good weeks here. One in 1915, one in 2015 and one in 2016. So.
I je to tada ja nekako dolazim sa agencijom Marian Pilgrimages, Marijanska hodočašća, a dvije godine zadnje sam došao sa Tomom i bili smo tu skupa tjedan dana.
And at the end of 2016, I began to get very worried. Tom didn't want to come home.
A negdje na koncu 2016. godine sam se počeo brinuti. Sad se Tom ne želi vratiti kući.
I was afraid that he wouldn't come home and I didn't know what to tell his mother.
Bilo me strah da se neće vratiti kući nikada i nisam znao kako ću to objasniti njegovoj mami.
A što je to što vas osobno tako privlači u Međugorju? Zašto se toliko rado vraćate i zašto vam je tako lijepo tu?
In the 80s, in 1980s, I could see Ireland going downhill. I could see the churches beginning to empty. I could feel the lack of respect for Christianity. It puzzled me. I didn't understand it. I still don't understand it. And every year it seems to be just getting more and more. The church is becoming sidelined. Christianity is not seen as important. Then I prayed that Our Lady would appear someplace, and I wished for it. I didn't realize she was already appearing in Međugorje. It's just funny.
Evo već 80-ih ja sam mogao osjetiti kako Irska ide nizbrdo. Vidio sam što se događa u našem društvu, vidio sam što se događa u našoj crkvi, vidio sam kako kršćanstvo postaje nepopularno, kako se crkve prazne, kako se ljudi odmiču od Boga. I ja sam se nekako već tada počeo moliti da se Gospa počne negdje ukazivati. Nisam ni znao da se ona ukazuje još tada u Međugorju.
So it is wonderful to come here to see so many people go to mass, to see so many people with respect for the church, with respect for the priests, to see so many people go to confession, especially when the confession boxes were being taken out of the churches at home. To see people sit down for so long and listen to a sermon. At home, people would look at their watches after 15 minutes. Is it going to go on much longer? It's so different. It's just wonderful. It's just beautiful. I love it.
Dakle, doći u mjesto gdje se ljudi toliko mole, gdje postoji tako intenzivan molitveni život, gdje se ljudi ispovjedaju u trenucima kada se ispovjedaonice potpuno uklanjaju iz naših crkava, gdje ljudi mogu dugo sjediti i slušati propovjedi, a mi doma, ono, nakon 50 minuta, 15 minuta, ljudi gledaju na sat, pitaju se hoće li svećenik nastaviti još govoriti, gdje postoji takvo poštovanje za crkvu i za svećenike. Za mene je to prekrasno. Dobro je biti ovdje.
Forgiven because you were forsaken. I'm accepted. You were condemned.
spirit is within me, because you died and rose again. Amazing love, how can it be, yes, that you, my King, would die for me, for me. Amazing love, I know it's true. It's my joy to honor you in all I do. I honor you, Lord. I'm forgiven because you were forsaken. I'm accepted. You were condemned. And I'm alive and well. Your spirit is within me because you died and rose again. Oh, we say, amazing love, how can it be that you, my King, would die for me? Amazing love, I know it's true, Lord. It's my joy. Your name, God, yeah, yes. Oh, sing it now. You are my King. We cry out and say, you are my King. Oh, forever. You are my King. Yes, you are my King. My King would die for me, oh Lord. Amazing love, I know it's true, it's true, it's true.
It's my joy to honor you.
Razgovoru s mladim Tomom, zapravo smo i potaknuti njegovom nazočnošću u Međugorju. Tom, kako se za tako malo vremena steknu prijatelji u potpuno nepoznatoj zemlji, nepoznatom mjestu, mi bismo rekli tuđem svijetu?
It's a good question. I don't know. People often ask me, what was I not frightened? I didn't speak any Croatian. I didn't know how the money system worked. I knew very little about the history of the country. I didn't know anything about this country, but I just knew, and I can't express over the radio how much I knew that it was where I was meant to be, and it was what I was meant to be doing.
Evo, to je dobro pitanje. U svakom slučaju, mnogi ljudi su me pitali, pa ideš u nepoznatu zemlju, nisam znao ni povijesne okolnosti, nisam znao ni kako funkcionira novčani sustav, baš ništa, skoro ništa nisam znao o ovoj zemlji. Ali ja sam jednostavno, to je čudno, kako sam ja u svom srcu samo imao taj duboki osjećaj da će sve biti u redu i da je sve upravo onako kako treba biti.
I had that undying faith, the undying belief that I'm not shy as a person, as you can gather, and I just knew that within a short period of time, I would gradually get to know people, and I would gradually get to know things, and my first step really was just going around Medjugorje, going to the different restaurants, having meals there, spending time there, and then within a short period of time I would have you know meet people.
I evo, nekako možete vidjeti da ja nisam od sebe stidljiv, da nemam problema sa tim, dakle mogu komunicirati, mogu razgovarati, a u početku ja nekako nisam imao nikakvih ni strahova, niti predrasuda, niti sam išto nešto posebno zamišljao. Jednostavno pošao bi negdje u restoran, sjeo bi, pojeo bih nešto, razgovarao bi, bilo je sasvim obično, osjećao sam se sasvim normalno.
So within a short period of time, as my mum said, the whole of Medjugorje knows me. In particular, the young people of Medjugorje, the young adults of Medjugorje, I'm very friendly, and I feel very, very, very more than I've ever felt at home anywhere here. I feel at home in England, of course. My mum is pulling a face here. of course, yes, I just feel fantastic, and everybody knows me, and I feel it's a great place, as Brother Senan said, everybody goes to Mass. It's great to see so many people going to Mass, so many young people going to confession, to see so many people going to confession. In particular, for me, one of the most powerful sights I've seen was the week leading up to Easter. The confessionals were overflowing.
Dakle, evo, ja sam, ne znam kako, ali ja sam se tako sprijateljila lako sa mladima koji su ovdje, sa mlađim parovima, sa odraslima. To je bilo tako nekako lako i normalno i teklo je posve uobičajeno. Ja sam se čak osjećao, više sam se osjećao da pripadam tu nego što pripadam u Engleskoj. Pa evo, moja mama je malo protestirala sa izrazom lica, ali nisam mislio doma, nego mislio sam više na to, na taj život koji je u Engleskoj, život koji je ovdje, gdje se ja osjećam posve prihvaćeno. I kao što je, jeli, brat Billy rekao, privukla me ta pobožnost, privukla me kako ljudi mole, kako i mladi odlaze na misu, a pogotovo ispovijed, taj sakramenat ispovijedi, ljudi koji čekaju, posebice evo kad se sjetim velikog tjedna i kako su ljudi čekali, nevjerojatno.
The power of the sight to see so many people going to Mass and to confession is just more than I can describe. I remember in the week leading up to Easter, young people would be coming past me and I'd be saying, where are you going? And they would say, I must go to confession. You'd never get that in England anymore.
Dakle, evo, ja nekako moram reći kako, posebice kad pričam o tom sakramentu ispovjedi, ja bih puno puta sreo mlade i ono pitam ih gdje ste pošli, ono kažu idemo na ispovjed. To se ne može doživjeti u Engleskoj. To se uopće ne može doživjeti više u Engleskoj.
And I really, I know I said I feel at home in Medjugorje, but as I said to somebody here the other day, I said, I feel so proud, so, so proud, and so, so happy to be able to call myself a part of this place. I feel so welcome here, and so at home here, and so, it's just, to be able to call myself, even though I'm not from Medjugorje, often I feel like I'm from Medjugorje.
Mjesto, ovo mjesto i sve što se događa ovdje, ja se doista ovdje osjećam kao doma. I I tako sam sretan i ponosan i čast mi je da se uopće mogu nazvati dijelom ovoga. I ako nisam iz Međugorja, ja se osjećam kao da sam ja ovdje.
A koliko se Tom dobro snašao u Međugorju i kako se uklopio u društvo, kako su ga prihvatili mladi ljudi, pokazuje ono što smo spomenuli na početku razgovora. Na Veliki petak nije bilo teško skupini mladića izdvojiti vrijeme, ostaviti svoje obitelji, svoje poslove i sve što su u tom danu imali i uzeti nosiljku, nositi Toma uz strmi križevac do vrha i spustiti ga natrag. Evo i mi smo ga susreli u tom uspinja, nju fotografirali i zbilja je to bio također dodatni poticaj, dodatni motiv da razgovaramo s tim mladićem koji sada boravi u Međugorju i koji možda svoj životni hendikep, boravak u kolicima, možda zahvaljuje Bogu jer je evo to bio put do Međugorja. No za kraj ovoga razgovora zamolit ću i Tomijevu mamu i prijatelja Bilija pa i samoga Toma za neke poruke u svezi Međugorja, u svezi života uopće.
I would like to say to the listeners, thank you very much for taking Tom into your hearts and accepting him and helping him and recognizing him and changing him, because it certainly has changed him being here for a long time, and he's very deep and meaningful now, and he wasn't like that before he came, but a lot of it is people of Medjugorje who help him and know him and wave at him, and I just want to say thank you to everybody who knows him and everybody who doesn't know him, because now after hopefully we've spoken about him you might go up and say, oh hi Tom.
Evo ja se želim zahvaliti svim ljudima iz Međugorja, svim onima koji poznaju Toma, koji su jeli svojom toplotom i svojim djelovanjem i svojim pozdravima i svojim gestama učinili da se on ovdje osjeća dobrodošle, da se osjeća kao da je doma. I evo svim onima koji ga ne poznaju, koji će možda nakon ove emisije odlučiti se prići mu, svim ljudima iz Međugorja se želim zahvaliti doista.
I'd like to say thank you to the people of Međugorje for responding to Our Lady's messages, for making them come alive and for giving hope to the rest of the world. Thank you very much.
Ja se želim zahvaliti ljudima iz Međugorja što su odgovorili na Gospine poruke, što su živjeli, počeli živjeti Gospine poruke i što su Gospine poruke oživjeli tako da ih i drugi ljudi iz ostatka svijeta mogu živjeti te na taj način imati nadu. Hvala vam puno.
I would like to say thank you to everybody. Thank you to the young people for your faith and it's so inspiring to see so many young people. So thank you to the young people of Medjugorje. Thank you to the boys from the heart who carried me up across the mountain. I can truly think that, you know, you showed a true act of fraternity. But also, just before I get cut off, I just wanted to thank the parish, thank for all they've done, in particular the priests and the sisters who serve here, people like Fra Marinko, who have inspired me and continue to teach me so much spiritually and inspire me so much as the days go on. I've struck up a great friendship with the sisters and with the priests here.
Ja se želim zahvaliti svima, i župi i mladima, posebice mladima koji su me nosili na Križevac. To je bilo prekrasno iskustvo i doista se može osjetiti taj bratski duh među svima njima, što je divno. A na drugoj strani, evo, zahvalan sam Bogu da sam ovdje, da sam u ovoj župi, da sam okružen sa svim tim ljudima i posebice sa svećenicama i časnim sestrama, a napose sa Fra Marinkom koji me tako nadjahnjuje i dakle koji mi jako puno pomaže u duhovnom smislu, i evo nekako zahvaljujem se svima njima na njihovom prijateljstvu i na potpori.
And thank you for this opportunity and the many opportunities and blessings and graces that I still receive, even though they're not physical graces and blessings, but I still receive so many blessings every day from everybody who lives here. And thank you, Vishnya, for this experience, for this opportunity to speak to the people of Medjugorje. And I'll just continue to pray for you all and to remember you in my thoughts and my prayers. And thank you very much from Arinko.
Evo ja se želim još jednom zahvaliti i doista su to nebrojni blagoslovi i milosti koje sam primio, koji se ne mogu, možda to nisu fizičke milosti koje se mogu opipati ili uzeti u ruke, ali su sigurno ogromne milosti. I hvala vam što ste mi dali mogućnost, dakle, da pričam, da uopće govorim na ovo, da se obratim slušateljima. I hvala vama Višnje što ste me pozvali, što ste odlučili napraviti emisiju sa mnom. I još jednom hvala vam, Marinku.
Planovi, ostaje li Tom i dalje u Međugorju?
I'm here on a period of discernment, and I'm actually discerning a call. I'm hoping, thinking of becoming a Franciscan, whether it be in this province as a priest or whether it be somewhere else. But yes, until the end of the year, I hope with God's help to be in Medjugorje, if not further into the future, depending on whether I, you know, what comes of the. My vocation and the Franciscans here of the Bosnian-Herzegovinian province.
I evo ja sam tu, ja sam još u fazi kada razlučujem svoj poziv i evo ne znam hoće li bi to biti da ću ja ostati ovdje, kao želim se priključiti Franjevcima, da li će to biti da ću ja ostati ovdje u ovoj provinciji ili ću završiti negdje drugo u svijetu. To sve ovisi o situaciji i o tome što će to razdoblje razlučivanja donijeti. A sigurno ostajem ovdje do kraja ove godine.
Hvala vam lijepa za sve što ste nam kazali. S nama su bili Billy Ryan, Catherine i njezin sin Thomas. Tom, 20-godišnji mladić iz Engleske koji je rođen sa cerebralnom paralizom, a koji tako rado boravi u Međugorju sa širokim osmijehom koji očito osvaja sve, pa tako lako dolazi i do tih prijateljstava, do te dobre komunikacije, da su ljudi čak spremni i na žrtvu i na jedinstvo u toj žrtvi za prijatelja. Hvala i vama, dragi slušatelji, što ste bili uz emisiju Susret. Razgovor je prevodila Tea Sušac, tonska realizacija Jure Vasilj, emisiju redla i vodila Višnja Spajić. Lijepo vas pozdravljamo do novoga susreta.